Hello and a very warm welcome to our daily service. This is a time of significant insecurity, but there's some things of which we can be completely certain. The Apostle John wrote the book of Revelation at a time of great insecurity. Not only do the people of God have to endure things like pandemics, plagues, as the ancient world called them, but also severe persecution. Some of their much-loved brothers and sisters had died. But John had a great vision. Although there was suffering on earth, this vision reminded him that all God's people, living and dead, were completely safe in the presence of God in heaven. Let's say together the words of Revelation chapter 7. After this I looked, and there before me was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, tribe, people, and language, standing before the throne and before the Lamb. They were wearing white robes and were holding palm branches in their hands, and they cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb." All the angels were standing round the throne and round the elders and the four living creatures. They fell down on their faces before the throne and worshipped God, saying, "Amen, praise and glory and wisdom and thanks and honour and power and strength be to our God for ever and ever. Amen." Loving Father, thank you for this great vision of all your people gathered in your presence, completely safe. May this vision encourage us as we go through these times of insecurity. For your name's sake. Amen. Do you remember those days when we used to plan for the future? When we'd write something in our diary and we could be pretty certain that that wedding was going to happen or that party was going to happen. And those days are gone, aren't they? And we've been reminded we're not in control. And if we're wise, we'll say as we plan something, at least under our breath, "If the Lord wills." But some things we can be sure of. We're looking this week at Paul's letter to the Thessalonians, the first of the letters. It's a young church, and Paul has just received from Timothy a report of how they're doing with some of their questions. And one of their concerns is about the fact that some believers have already died. And they're wondering, are they missing out? And we saw yesterday, Paul said, not at all. They're at rest, sleeping with Christ. And one day in the future, there'll be a glorious reunion. Let's continue in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. According to the Lord's word, we tell you that we who are still alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet call of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. After that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. We saw yesterday, rest now for those who died in Christ, reunion later. I've got some more R's for you today. First, return. The dead in Christ, those who are asleep with him, are certainly not missing out. Paul says, verse 16, "For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet call of God. There'll be a great fanfare, and then Christ will come again." When we put something in our diary, it's always provisional. When God puts something in his diary, it's guaranteed, because he's in control of everything. And there's one great saving event left in his diary, the return of Christ. It will happen. Return, and then resurrection. Paul continues, once Christ returns, the dead in Christ will rise first. Resurrection. The ultimate state for Christians is not to be souls in heaven, but to be physical beings in a physical new creation. once Christ returns, there'll be resurrection, and then reunion, the reunion we thought about briefly yesterday. Paul continues, after that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so we will be with the Lord forever. Well, there are mysterious elements in that verse. The clouds represent the presence of God. Mystery, but what is clear is that those who are in Christ will be with the Lord, a glorious union with him. Now we know him by the Holy Spirit, then we'll be physically in his presence. Reunion with the Lord and with one another, all God's people, united together in Christ, in his presence. It's glorious. And what's the response, our final R, verse 18? Therefore, encourage one another with these words. Perhaps you're mourning someone who died in Christ. What an encouragement these words are. For all of us facing many uncertainties, we need the encouragement of a guaranteed and glorious future. We're going to express our faith now in a creed based on some words of 1 Peter chapter 1. And they're words that speak gloriously of our certain hope. Let's say together, we believe in God the Father, by whose great mercy we have been born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. We believe in God the Son, who died for our sin and rose again for our justification. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. First, a prayer for those who mourn. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved, the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have the strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, and in thankful remembrance of your great goodness in past years. And for those who died in Christ, in the sure expectation of a joyful reunion in the heavenly places. This we ask in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In the silence, let's bring before the Lord those we're concerned for, those in any kind of need. Lord our Father, we pray for all who are troubled at this time. Bring healing to the sick, strength to those who care for them, relief to those in pain, friendship to those who are alone, and reassurance to those in doubt or distress of mind. May our love be so strong that seeing need, we may never pass by on the other side. We ask this in Christ's name. Amen. Our song is a great hymn of Charles Wesley that speaks of the glorious return of Christ. Do join in.
Say
Well, whatever we face this day and all our days, let's keep our eyes fixed on that glorious future that is to come. A final prayer of blessing. May the God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ Jesus, establish, strengthen, and settle you in the faith. May the blessing of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and all those you love, both now and forevermore. Amen.